The research councils perform a really important function in the UK, so helping shape their policies is really part of that loop about making sure we get the best answer for UK research.
The meetings are always stimulating. We always need people who are willing to engage in debate, really contribute. And it's really important that we have a diversity of approach and a diversity of views.
I applied. I never thought for a minute that I'd actually get the job, but I thought it would be a useful experience. And actually, it's been a fantastic thing to do. I find it intellectually very stimulating, very interesting. It's actually very good fun.
First of all, you get to meet some really interesting people. Secondly, you learn a lot about what's happening in the environment that's important to your science, whether you're in industry or you're in academia. And lastly, you do feel you have a role in shaping that agenda.
I think one of the things, if anyone comes forward through these processes, is we are none of us very sure exactly what a research council governing body does. And it is around engaging with strategy, it is around engaging with the politics of how we get more support from government for UK research. I certainly feel one of my roles has been to help shape the importance of communicating both with our stakeholders and the academic communities and feeding back messages from them about concerns and issues, but equally importantly, helping them shape the case in times of constrained funding about the real benefits for the United Kingdom.
The best candidate doesn't necessarily mean that you are the top expert in your particular area. It's somebody who can also bring a broader perspective.
I'm one of, I think, four non-academic members of the Arts and Humanities Research Council. I'm certainly very well aware that there's much about the academic world of my colleagues and peers that I don't know. On the other hand, I hope that I can bring something in that might be a perspective that's different to them.
I think what being on the MRC Council has given me is an extraordinary breadth of vision right across medical research. And actually, I find it's very helpful to me in the broadcasting I do, for instance, because I've been involved with the MRC and I'm much more familiar with its work and with the huge variety of medical research that it funds.
I personally understand strategy, communication and the funding landscape much better as an individual. That, I think, positions me better in my own institution and frankly has some selfish career benefits in being able to advocate that I have had those experiences.
The research councils have to maintain a really delicate balance between exciting blue skies research and showing their impact for both the economy and society, but also understanding where the science is going and really being able to anticipate the hot areas that are going to come up in the future.
There's a lot of evidence that diverse management teams make better decisions and have a beneficial impact on their organisations. So I think there are really important pragmatic reasons why we want a diverse governing body. I think it's also really important in terms of holding up role models to earlier career researchers. I think it's particularly important that we encourage more women and ethnic minority researchers to come forward. Both groups are underrepresented. Those individuals who can give some insights to what policy changes might be needed, what strategies might need to be further developed to encourage more participation from women and ethnic minority researchers. And I think it's really important to role model for those communities that we are a diverse group and that we represent the whole research base, not only one part of it.
The success of what we're seeing at the moment is the result of people's work over the years, careful, considered work, a lot of money that's gone into research and gone into funding the right projects at the right times, and that's what we're aiming for.
It does take up some time, but it isn't a hugely onerous time commitment, and it's also a very planned time commitment, so you know the days that you will be involved. It's tremendously rewarding. I don't think any of us in council have ever felt there's been a single meeting where we haven't been doing important work for the common good of the UK. But it's also really important we get a diverse range of people coming forward from different disciplines, from different universities and from different external organisations. It's a really important role and it's a really rewarding one.